first part, I is something that I use when a student is asked to look at a video. Okay, so the content, part of that content is how I would decide their report on the video should be graded. They should be clear about their theme. They should include the vocab, the grammar that they are seeing at that point in the chapters. They should reflect an opinion, or at least come up with a question. It was okay for me if the opinion was a question that they came up. I just wanted them to go one step forward than just reporting to me what they read. And just a reaction, you know, an original reaction to what they were seeing or reading. And the style, they organized their ideas logically, and they edited, because they had to give me their little script that they wrote for the film. So I was able to kind of look at that. And then the oral evaluation, second part. Again, that's part of an oral interview sheet that I use that is longer. So I took just a part of it. And that's how the rubric came about, because for myself, more than for them, I needed to be very clear about how to grade this. It was the first time for me, so I wanted to have a way of being as fair as possible and looking at what the components could be. And then I gave them a grade after at midterm. They got a grade because they had to complete four by midterm. And then at the end of the semester, they got another grade. So this was used to give a grade for four flips each time. It could be changed a little bit. You could just grade each one individually, but it would have been, I need to sleep. So that would have been impossible, okay? So after I developed that, at the very beginning of class, we took, I think it was the second day after the syllabus and so on, the second day of class, and Patricia will talk about that. They were in the lab and they were trained on using the camera. And she's going to talk about the training and the technical aspects on how to do that. So they knew where to find the cameras, how to check them out, how to use them, how to save, how to convert, all of that. They had the rubric, they knew how they were going to be graded, where to go. So all of that had to be set up in advance before I could start doing this. Okay. I'm going to show you, before I show you some of the examples, one of the things that I wanted to point out is that the flips, I was thinking speaking skills, but they really do more than that, okay? Because in the background, you have the students scanning this media, scanning the newspapers, the foreign media, looking for something that's important, looking at headlines, discriminating, trying to decide what's going to be important enough. And while they're doing that, they're acquiring some information, okay? So they're reading, they're scanning, and they're also writing, and they have to write in Spanish their little script. My hope was that they would memorize. It didn't quite come to that, but some did a partial job of memorizing and speaking. They were trying to make themselves look natural in front of a camera. Some just plainly read, but that's okay. At that point, I did not mind, because they were reading their own words, and that was writing, reading and writing. So there were two steps that they had to take before they can just speak into the camera. My rough statistics, I would say about maybe, okay, we're talking 25, 22, 24, about almost 70 students, maybe a little more. I'd say about 25% of them by the second half were doing a much better job. So they were improving. 50%, 55 probably remained static. And then we have another 25% that seemed worse. But they had one thing in common, and they were the last minute doers, whereas the day before the end of the semester, they were trying to do this and do all the four at the same time, which really made it very difficult for us. In spite of the fact that I had said, I want you to do this every other week. Next time it will be on the syllabus every other week, because I was really loose in the sense of you have 6 weeks, 7 weeks to do four. I did that because our cadets at VMI, their schedule is really compressed. They don't have an awful lot of free time, so I had to take that into consideration. But it created a problem for grading for me, and particularly for Patricia at the end, because there was a last minute crunch that it really took me to the wall as far as endurance is concerned for both of us. It was a marathon. But I'm not complaining about that. I'm just gonna take a break here, and I'm gonna take you to the examples. They're very short. I did four examples. Two are about world news. In this case, they were both about Spain. And the other two were about life at VMI. And of course, they're about food. I want you to notice that one of them in particular had three cadets. They're not supposed to do this. They're supposed to do this individually. Cadets will always find a way. Their explanation was, which was really true because I actually started timing this, that they had, each of them spoke for the amount of time. They didn't quite, but they figured that it was okay. So giving support to each other. By and large, though, they did it individually. Some of them were very funny, but these are the serious ones. Before I open them, I want to know if anybody has any questions so far.
Did you open these up to the class? Did they have the expectation that the other students would be watching these as well, or was it just for your eyes?
No, they were for my eyes, their eyes. Of course, they could show them to whoever they wanted. But I asked these students for permission to use these.
Do you think the public performance aspect of it might improve the quality? If you maybe, I don't know, had one of them perhaps said, okay, this one's got to go.
I will tell you why I didn't make it public, okay? Students are hesitant to speak in class when everyone else is listening. And my goal is always to keep a very low, as low as I can get it, effective filter. I want them relaxed and smiling, so they're learning. When they get uptight, it's very difficult to get them to speak or to get them to learn, for that matter. So I wouldn't want to show anything in the class unless I had permission.